最終戦 USSR 対チェコスロバキアの試合を開始いたします。
Thank you. Austria's journey to qualify for the final rounds of the Olympics starts with a tough one, the Russians. At the focal point of the Soviet attack is Danny Gretsch, the man I stood in for in that very same gold mouth during Olympic training. It's the toughest evening of Danny's life. The Russians take on nation after nation. They're never in any danger until their last game. A game that unexpectedly turns against them from the outset. Russia's opponents, Czechoslovakia. A team well prepared for this Olympic final and passionately committed to beating the Soviet Union. This will be a fierce conflict. Ice hockey laced with drama, emotion, and above all, aggression. The first Russian goal comes 12 minutes into the second period. It's a vital goal that brings the Soviet Union back into the game after being two goals down. Russian equalizer comes at a bad time for Czechoslovakia. Less than 3 minutes before the end of the second period. Their confidence regained, the Soviet Union will now be hard to beat. Nine minutes from time, the Czechs pierce the Russian defense and find their mark through Edward Novak. Thank you. In the 54th minute, a foul forces Novak into the penalty box. It's a deadly blow for Czechoslovakia. 1 minute later, the Russians equalize. There are less than 5 minutes left to play. The score, 3-3. The Soviet Union capitalized on their advantage, leaving the Czechs no time to recover. 24 seconds later, Russia scores the winner. Their final assault is staged to perfection.
In the match between Canada and the Soviet Union, Canada was rendered powerless as the Soviets maintained their undefeated status. The final score was 4-0. The Soviet hockey team's magnificent performance is concluded with a gold medal victory over the Czechs. And Vladislav Tretiak, goaltender in four Olympics, the soul of the team, retires. Tretiak said, "We are here only for the gold medal, and no one can beat us." The Soviets finished undefeated, and Tretiak said farewell.